Okay, so now let's talk about frequency. So in the analog domain, that's obviously easy. So if we have a look at an analog signal here, in our convention XA of t, that's our time. So let's draw a nice sine wave here. So the sine wave has a length of tau seconds, and then obviously our frequency, which we're getting out there, is just 1 over tau. So that's in seconds, and that's in hertz. So that's easy. So now in the sample domain, we are losing this temporal information. So remember, xn is xa of nt. So t is our sampling interval, and n is just our index number, our sample number. And then, so xa is our analog signal here, and this is our digital signal. So the question now is, so how can we represent frequency here? So what is frequency in this domain here? And in order to get a bit closer to that, we could just define, and let's just first write down properly a sine wave. So let's take another sheet and let's define a sine wave in our analog domain. So we've got our xa of t, and so let's write a cosine 2 pi f t. Yeah, so that's our analog frequency here. Analog frequency, and that's just the amplitude, how we expect this. So now, remember, if we sample this, so our t is essentially n divided by fs, by our sampling rate, or n multiplied by t, our sampling interval. So we can turn this into xa of t a cosine, and then 2 pi. So we've got our analog frequency f here, and now we substitute the t in here as n divided by fs. So we could do that. So let's look. So now we are working here in the sample domain. So instead of having a continuous function, we are, I just draw this here as a dotted line. We are getting points like this here out there. Now the question is, what is the maximum frequency we can actually achieve here? So let's think of maximum frequency in terms of samples. So let's draw this here. Let's be careful that we're not going out of the screen here. So the maximum frequency, what we need for this here is, let's draw this here, otherwise we are getting out of the screen. So for the maximum frequency, we just draw two samples here. And we could obviously imagine our sine wave going like this. So we need two samples here to represent a wave. So anything higher won't work anymore, because we need basically one peak and one valley here. Yeah, so we need two samples for maximum frequency. So now let's define on the basis of this here a normalized frequency. So that we're defining our frequency on the basis that this is the highest frequency here we can get. So normalized frequency, write this down here again, this xa of t a equals cosine 2 pi f n divided by fs. So what we see here, we've got here the frequency of the wave, and here we've got our sampling rate fs. So what we can do is now we can define our normalized frequency just by f divided by fs. Yeah, so as this is our normalized frequency. So let's test this, that if f, so maximum frequency is then f 0.5. Okay, so let's test if this actually works. Let's just write this down here again. So that's our s over fs, and so f equals 0.0 is the maximum frequency. So let's put this in our cosine function here. X of n is cosine of 2 pi n f. So this gives us here cosine pi n. Okay, so how does it look like for n equals 0? Our x of 0 gives us 1, and for n equals 1 this gives us a minus 1. So in other words, so if we start here with n equals 0 and we are getting a positive peak here at 1, and then at n equals 1 here we are getting a negative peak here, yeah, so there, and so on and so on. So then essentially for f equals 0.5 we are getting here the maximum frequency out there. So that's quite nice in terms of normalization. Just a word of caution, just while we're about this here. So MATLAB and also Octave, they use a different normalization. In MATLAB, there's a maximum frequency. The maximum frequency is 1. So we need to, if we do our calculations here for MATLAB and Octave, we just need to multiply everything by factor 2.